So the last black and gray series I made has actually gotten quite a few views, and I've been getting actually quite a few comments and a few repeating comments. People seem to think that I'm scrunching up my paper towel on top of my leg. So I just wanted to dispel that really quick because people trying to school me on silly things just kind of irks me a little bit. So I set up a camera as a side view so you could actually see where my hand is at. I'm not scrunching up my paper towel on my pant leg, okay? So I did it quite a few times to try and get myself into my normal routine, my normal habits. I've been asked if I will be making more videos. I won't be making them consistently because you may have noticed there's a lot that goes into making these. I have three different cameras going. I've got the ink cam, I've got the close-up cam and the head cam, and then I have to edit all those together, and I have to come up with the narration, and it also can be a little imposing on my client at the time as well. People might not know, but I don't really make any money off these videos. I'm clearly not trying to drive traffic to a Patreon page where I can make money because I don't have a Patreon page. And I'm not really interested right now in having a Patreon page simply because that's a lot of work. That's a lot more work on top of my already busy schedule that I have. Now, me personally, I would love to make more videos on art theory, but what I've seen is the art theory stuff just really isn't all that popular, which is weird to me because to me, the art theory is what helps you become a better artist. I actually have quite a bit of footage from old tattoos that I've done that I've never really done anything with. If I get some time and some motivation, maybe I can go through some of this footage and put something together. Some of the footage is not very good. The angles are bad, the lighting's bad. However, I do have an old video that I've never done anything with where I was describing my entire process of working on a fake skin. I can't do the Morgan Freeman one because I did that video for the Master Tattoo Institute. However, I do have this video of this little dog that was created by Norina Bucci. So I'll go ahead and include part of it here. I think there's some good information that might be helpful to some people. For this exercise, I will be using a piece of artwork by an artist from New York named Norina Bucci. Since the artwork is all ready to go, all I need to do is create the stencil. So I'm going to create the stencil in Procreate. I'm going to create a new document. I just did screen size. Then I'm going to import a photo. And here is Norina Bucci's artwork. And all I'm doing, I've created a new layer, so I'm not drawing on the actual artwork layer. And I'm just tracing it with a red technical pen. I like to use a technical pen because it's solid no matter how much pressure you apply. It's a nice solid even line. And I'm going through and finding all the elements, the very notable landmarks, and tracing those so that I can use those during the tattoo process to help me know where everything is at. After I've finished the line work, I select the line layer. Because I used a red pen, I want to change it to black. So as long as I have that layer selected, I can go up into the adjustments layer and choose the hue, brightness, saturation adjustment. And then I just turn the brightness all the way down, and that will turn the lines to black. And just to make sure that the lines are as black as I can get them, I duplicate the layer a few times, and then I combine all the layers together. That gets those lines nice and black. That'll ensure that the thermal copier or thermal printer will make a really good solid stencil. So next, I share the image as a JPEG to my photos. That way, I can pull it into my computer and size it appropriately and get it printed out into a stencil. So here I'm in my photos on my computer. I'm retrieving the exported image. And once I find it, I'm just going to pull that onto my desktop. And then I'm going to open up Photoshop. And I'm going to create a new document. I always do an 8 by 10 just because that always prints out very easily on my printer. And then I'm going to drag that image in from my desktop into Photoshop. And now I'm going to size it. So I have rulers set up on my document so that I can pull guides down and find the measurements. So I'm going to take my ruler and I'm going to check the size of this fake skin and figure out what's going to be a good size to make this stencil. So 8 inch by 6 inch seems to be the measurement that's going to look good. So I go in to Photoshop and I select my move tool just so I can easily move these guides around. And I set one at 1 inch and one at 9 inch. So that'll be my 8 inch height. Then I set one at one and one at seven. That gives me 6 inches across. So now I'm going to resize the stencil layer and try and get it to fit within there. And what I notice is there's a lot of space in the vertical direction. So I'm going to recheck my measurements, consider what orientation I'm going to have my skin. And I'm just going to check again. I'm going to see if I can get a little more width on it just so that I can have a little bit more height. And I see that I can do 6.5 inches width and it'll still look pretty good on there. So I'm going to move my guides a quarter inch in either direction so that now I've got those showing me where 6.5 inches is. And I'm going to resize the stencil again so that the nose is right against one guide and the ear is right against the other. So that way, when I print it out, it will be 6.5 inches wide. So I'm going to go ahead and print that out. While that's printing out, I'll get my skin ready. And then I'm going to cut out around the stencil. And then I'm going to lay it on my skin just to make sure the size looks good. Once I'm happy with that, I'm going to get my stencil paper. That blue thing is the stencil paper carrier that helps keep the paper from getting fried when it goes through the thermal copier. It makes just a much clearer stencil. So I'm going to put the stencil in between the yellow backing paper and the carbon. Remove the protective sheet in the middle. Make sure I have it positioned good to use the stencil paper efficiently. Put it into the blue carrier, and then I'm going to feed it into the thermal copier. And the stencil is done. And now all I need to do is just cut out the stencil. So this was the thermal copier method. Next, I'm going to show you the stencil printer method. The stencil printer will use the exact same paper as the thermal copier, so I'll get another sheet of that. Now, just like with the thermal copier, you have to remove that protective sheet on the inside, the brown one, otherwise it will not print. For my particular stencil printer, which is a Brother S8, I need to remove the yellow backing paper. So I will fold it back and then crease it and then tear along the crease. And then I turn the S8 stencil printer on. And then I carefully feed the end of the paper where they're all joined into the printer. And then I press the feed button to feed it in until I see it come out the bottom. Then I lift the front tray, which allows me to realign the paper and get it nice and straight and even. Then I put the front tray back down. The paper is all positioned, and now it's ready to be printed. Now, in this method, I need to actually flip the artwork because it's going to print it backwards on the stencil paper. For this particular printer, the ink needs to be very, very dark to get a good stencil. So even though I made it as dark as I could in Procreate, I'm just going to cover my bases and make it even darker in Photoshop. So I duplicate the artwork layer and then I set its blend mode to multiply so that it makes it even darker. Then I duplicate that multiply layer a few more times. And then I put them all into a group so that I can position it down at the bottom of the paper. Then I flip the artwork horizontally and I'm ready to print. The settings I like to use on my S8, I like to have the density set to 10, and I like to have the print speed set to the absolute slowest, 1.1. Then I just cut it out like I did before, and that's how you make a stencil with the S8 stencil printer. The last method you could use for making stencils is doing it by hand. I have a different type of stencil paper for doing the stencils by hand. It's just like the other one, but it has a heavier duty stencil paper on it. I'm going to grab some tape because I'm going to need to actually tape the artwork to the stencil paper so it doesn't move around. And I'm going to grab a pen, something that's nice and firm to trace the artwork. And just like before, you need to remove the protective paper on the inside. Now for this method, you do not need to flip the artwork like we did for the stencil printer. So I'm going to use the artwork that I printed out for the first method, the thermocopier, and I'm going to tape it to the back of this stencil paper. And now you just trace over the artwork. And once you're finished, go ahead and cut it out just like the other stencils. And there you have it. Those are three different methods for creating a stencil for tattoos.